Hi students, in this video I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about animal fiber, especially we have been talking about another sub-concept related to the chapter is story of wool. In the process of obtaining wool, there we should follow some steps. In the last video, what we have talked in the process of obtaining wool, we have talked about shearing, scouring or washing. These two steps we have spoken in the last class. So in this video, what I'm going to talk to you is what is classing or sorting. What is sorting? And next, what is combing? Okay. After combing, what is spinning? As much as possible, let us finish all the concepts related to this process of obtaining silk in this video. But here, especially let me start about classing or sorting. In the process, after the wool is washed, after it is treated with cool air, after it is dried, the wool is piled up, and in sorting process, the wool may be with cut fleece. Okay, the wool may be with long and broken, and the wool may be with short and broken, and the wool may be with perfect wool. The wool may be with perfect, no problem at all. So, and the wool may be with some unwanted things like leaves, twigs, etc. See, what we have to do? We have to separate all of these things and we have to pile up separately. Pile up in separate places. Pile up means making a heap. Okay? Making a heap of wool, right? See, in this process we have to separate the cut fleece or broken fleece, completely broken. Cut in the sense, here you can understand, broken fleece. So broken fleece in one place, long and broken one place, short and broken in one place, and perfect fleece in another place. So they have to pile up in separate places. So doing this process is called what? Classing or sorting. We can say the quality of the wool like this. In the broken fleece is not better quality, and you know that comparing to perfect fleece, it's a perfect, you know, it's a better quality of fleece and comparing to other three fleece like this, and you have to pile up them and you have to follow the next step. Yeah, after doing this, after piling up them, what is the next level? What is the next step followed? Combing. What is the next step followed? Combing. How combing is done? Before combing, the piled up wool, you know, that's colored with different colors. Colored with different colors. Coloring is also important. Okay, after classing or sorting process, the piled up wool is colored with different colors to give attraction to the wool. Okay, and after that is colored, dried. Coloring is called dyeing. This is also called as, here another process after classing or sorting, here you can put dyeing, dyeing. Okay, dyeing is done to give attraction to the wool. Along with dyeing process, it's bleached even. Bleaching is also done. Bleaching is also followed. So bleaching process is also done. And then finally, it is combed. Combing is done using machines or by manually. Here, in the combing process, the combing may be done by machines, you know, and sometimes it is done by hand even. Okay, students, the tool used for combing may has a long teeth. Okay, the wool is pulled. The wool is pulled with the help of a long teeth comb. Okay, the wool is pulled between the long teeth of a comb. The comb which has long teeth, and after it is combed, it is rolled like a rope using a machine, that rollers. We can call them as rollers. Combing and rolling. Rolling is done. It comes out like a big rope. It comes out like a big rope with the help of a machine called rolling machine. Okay, that is drawn between the rolls. You know, that comes out like a big rope, that is pulled out like a rope. And once it is rolled out like a big rope, at the same time, there is another machine which takes few fibers from the big rope and twists and makes a thread. Okay? The process is called spinning. After rolling what? Spinning. Here in this video, I want to stop till the spinning process. Here, let me review these points. First of all, sharing we talked about in the previous class, and scouring or washing in the previous class. In this class, we started talking about classing or sorting. In the process, the wool is exposed to cool air, and that is piled up and sorted. The grading, this is nothing but graded or classed, classing or separated based on the quality of the wool, and then that is colored. Next, combing, and in the process, bleaching is also done, coloring is also done, and then combing is done by machines which have a long teeth, and after it is combed, that is rolled out with the help of a machine, it comes out like a big rope, and from the rolled wool, few fibers are taken separate and then twisted them and made into yarn or thread. That's nothing but spinning process. Finally, we will get here woolen thread. Making woolen thread is also called as whirling spool process. Whirling spool process. And after it is made into a thread, the thread is used to make different fabrics. The fabrics are nothing but woolen fabrics. Okay, and how woolen fabrics are made and all, we will see in the next class. This is for today, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.